We have a total of 13 tigers.
Hunter!
Yeah, you can
Good
hear
boy.
You.
Come on.
And Hunter's one of the most special and unique.
Boy. From the top of the grandstand.
Hunter is nearly 5 years of age now. I was lucky enough to be here since he was born. His mother, Caitlin, and father, Ramelon, know him very, very well. He knows us very well. And, yeah, a great cat. He's awesome. Hunter really enjoys our company, and he's very tactile.
G'day.
I think that basically comes down to his lack of eyesight. One of the vocalisations the tigers make is called a prooston, or we affectionately call it a chuff. And that noise sounds a little bit sort of like that. And that sound is actually them greeting us when they're saying hello, when they're happy or affectionate. It's important for handlers to chuff back to the cats when they chuff to us, and that helps, I guess, bridge that gap and maintain the strong relationship that we have with them.
Good boy.
Today is a very special day at Australia Zoo because Hunter is getting his annual eye checkup. A rare degenerative disease took his sight.
His eyes now are totally fake. This annual check is really the only chance we've got to have a close look at his eyes and just make sure we're monitoring for any changes or if there's any issues we need to be concerned about. It's really in Hunter's best interest that he's relaxed, that he's comfortable, so we're going to be sedating him, knocking him out, to allow the veterinary staff to have a close look at his eyes. You don't want him waking up, put it that way. So once we get him on leash, we'll bring him in. I think we'll let him wander around, have a smell for a minute or two.
Sure.
We'll just use milk, like we've been doing with him.
So if you have him here...
Yeah, I'll bring him up here with the milk. I'll get you on the outside, might be the go.
If I stand about here...
I think so. If you can inject him from here...
Yep. And I'll go for the rump area.
Yep. Once he's down, we'll cuff him.
Yep.
Oh, you're chuffing
at him. You're chuffing at him.
Come on, in here. At the end of the day, he's still a wild animal. He has all of his teeth and all of his claws. He's got all of his instincts. They're not tame or domesticated, no matter how long they've been in captivity.
Okay, syringe. That's the one.
Don't jab yourself.
All right, so how many mils have we got in there?
Two mils, exact same amount as usual. Looks like a lot, but you'll be fine. Good luck.
Hey, Hunter, what's this? Milk? Are you ready, buddy? Bring him around. What's this? What's this? Milk? Good boy. Good boy.
Okay, you ready?
Tell me when.
Okay. Done.
Good boy, buddy. Good boy. Within a few minutes, he'll start to feel a bit drowsy, and then he'll obviously be unconscious.
Good boy. Good boy.
Anytime you're dealing with a tiger, obviously there are certain risks involved. Nice and easy, nice and easy. With him being blind, you'll find that that can compound. You know, he can get a bit nervous because he can't actually see things if he hears things.
Hunter. Good boy.
The biggest risk is while he's going down that he might regurgitate or vomit, and of course, if he's still a little bit light, we can't really intervene.
It's been a few minutes since we've administered the anaesthesia.
That's good. That's pretty good.
So he's just gone unconscious now, so we really have to move quickly, get in there, and just make sure that everything goes to plan.
Still a bit of stimulus there.
We have to make sure to time this to the gnat's eyebrow because we're sedating a very large animal, and as a side effect of sedation, sometimes they have a little trouble with their breathing. So we don't want to have any lag time between Hunter falling asleep and getting to the hospital.
There's a little bit of eye twitch, but that'll be the ketamine, won't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
So as long as he's got no...
If you flick his ear, there's nothing
ear flick?
There. No, there's no ear flick. Yeah.
Well, this is the exciting part. So I've got the restraints for his legs so that should he become light, he's not going to pose any threat to anyone. So at this point, we just need to watch his breathing very closely. They tend to breath hold a little bit.
When tigers are under sedation, they take either very, very shallow breaths or they hold it for a while.
Come on, buddy. He's slightly aware. So physiologically, we may be able to stimulate breathing by tapping on him, by rubbing him vigorously. If he'll take a breath from that stimulation, then we have a better chance of getting him breathing regularly. There's the little one.
It's really important the vets intubate him, so put the tube down his throat, get him on oxygen.
So I'm going to need to put my arm in to feel where the larynx is. So this is a little bit of a risk for me.
Tongue?
Yeah. Okay. There's a breath. There we go.
Good boy, buddy.
Good boy.
Good boy, Hunter.
Yeah, that's getting a bit of a reaction.
Yeah.
And so we just need to work quite quickly to get that tied in, and then we can actually breathe for him if we need to get him a little bit deeper.
Do you know, just pull him out and put it in here?
Everything's gone like clockwork, but at 278 pounds, it's a lot of tiger to get on a stretcher, so it's very exciting.
Okay, so I think, yeah, we're good to get the stretcher in place.
I'm just going to move him out a bit, Sam, if you're happy with that.
Sure. Yeah.
Three. We're not budging him, guys.
Yeah, holy dooly. He's a heavy boy. So when they talk about these tigers being among the smallest breed of tigers, you wouldn't think it when you lift him. So good job getting him on there, guys. Okay, great.
Okay, yeah, we're good to go.
Great.
Watch his paws. We'll take him down to our veterinary clinic, which is on site, and the specialists have a very close look at his eyes to see if everything's going well with the implants.
Good grief, buddy.
Here we go. Oh, he's sliding off.
Sliding off.
Yeah. Hunter holds a very special place in all the handlers' hearts. We'll definitely be praying that he comes out healthy at the other end. We really want to have the specialist tell us that his eyes are fine, they're the same or even better would be good, because I guess he's one of our favourite cats. We've got to make sure that that he comes out healthy for sure.
With Hunter, we want to make sure that his eyes are physically healthy and happy and comfortable. Even though he can't see, he still needs to be comfortable.
Pop him up here.
Do you want him to go forward a bit or happy?
Yeah, maybe just forward a little bit. Yep.
So he's a bit more.
Okay, so we'll just get him re-stabilised now that we've got him into the surgery. We just need to make sure that his anaesthetic depth is good. We're getting his IV line hooked back up again. We'll start doing a temperature and a heart rate, and then we'll be able to do his exam.
It's nice that we don't have to do this very often. For the most part, simple vet checks can be done hands-on without sedating him. But for something as intricate as checking his prosthetic eyes, it's important to have him completely sedated.
Pauline's our specialist veterinary ophthalmologist who comes and does lots of work with us. So does lots of species, and today she's looking at the tiger. We will need to turn the lights out for the procedure, won't we? So we'll go ahead and do that now. Pauline's just doing what's called a Schirmer tear test, so it's measuring tear production, just making sure that he's got adequate lubrication naturally in his eyes.
Well, it's been 2 days now since we did the general anaesthetic with Hunter. He woke up, no problems at all. He's basically back to his normal self. Not even knowing that he went down to the hospital to get his eyes checked, I guess.
Hunter, target. Good boy.
Very happy to say that the whole process was very successful. We found that the eyes were fairly healthy.
Target.
So for us, we'll just keep monitoring it and then have another checkup in 12 months' time. What do you think, buddy?
Are
you gonna make a mess of this?
It's so special that Jeff's able to have a relationship with his tigers. And this includes an element of trust between himself and these beautiful animals. He's someone who doesn't take it for granted, and he loves each and every tiger very much.
Oh boy. What do you reckon?
Go, buddy.
I hope that Hunter has a long, healthy life with us here at the zoo. I know I'll be doing everything I can to ensure that happens.
It's just there, buddy. Go and have a look.
That's a good boy. The other staff we have working here, the other handlers, feel exactly the same way. That's all right. I just want him to enjoy his life with us.